Let's build up our linear model for price. I'm going to store the first model in a variable called m1. You probably also noticed how I used the I wrapper around each of the variables. The I stands for as is. In this case, it tells R to use the expression inside the I function to transform a variable before using it in the regression. This is instead of instructing R to interpret these symbols as part of the formula to construct the design matrix for the regression. You can read more about the syntax for linear models in the instructor notes. I can also update the previous model to add the caret variable in the regression using this syntax. The real functional relationship is surely not as simple as the cubed root of caret, so we add a simple linear function of caret in our model predicting price. And we can continue to make more complex models by adding more variables. We add cut, even though we don't expect it to have much influence on price. Next, we add color to a fourth model and clarity to a fifth. When we run the code, we can see that we're getting some very nice R-square values. We're accounting for almost all the variance in price using the four C's. If we want to know whether the price for a diamond is reasonable, we might now use this model.